Hello and welcome to the Medel Spotlight Series. My name is Johanna Boyer. I'm a musicologist and research associate here at Medel. Joining me today is Joe Duarte from Virginia. He is the co-CEO of InnoCaption. He is a bilateral cochlear implant user, and he's a big fan of Andrea Bocelli. Hello, Joe. Thank you so much for coming all the way to meet us here and taking the time and share your experience.
My pleasure. Thank you for inviting me.
Of course. It's great to have you here. In this episode, we will be focusing on music sound quality, and the importance of music training in rehabilitation. So let me start with asking you, could you please share a little bit about your hearing journey?
Sure. I was hearing, I believe, until I was 3 years old, and then I lost my hearing at that time. I was living in Portugal. I was born in Portugal, and I was adopted in Portugal, and there were no hearing aids in that. So my parents flew with me to New York City to get my first hearing aids. Mm-hmm. And I got a body aid, and I remember the moment the sound got activated and I heard, it was loud. And that moment when I started hearing, I went through a rehab process of learning how to hear and speak and so forth. And that went through many years. And then I discovered that I enjoyed music with my hearing aids, very much so at the time. And as time went on, I lost my hearing even further. And I went from a body aid to behind the ear, and I lost my ability to enjoy music. And it was not until I got my cochlear implants that I discovered music in a big way. And so now music means everything to me, you know.
So how long have you had your cochlear implants?
I got my first cochlear implant in 2008, mm-hmm. and my second one in 2010. So it's going 15 years, pretty much. And it's been an amazing journey. And the thing about it is that I had a big gap without music. Mm-hmm. And from the first day I got my cochlear implant, I started listening to music. And I've been listening to music every day without fail.
So while you were in this decision process to get a cochlear implant and to get a Medel cochlear implant, did music play a role?
Oh, definitely. That was the hold off. I waited so long to get a cochlear implant because I had heard that the music was not good with cochlear implants. And so it was not until I found Medel and the way they designed the electrode with the deeper insertion to be able to access the low frequencies that I became convinced that the way this cochlear implant is designed is going to give me access mm-hmm. to music in a way that that I knew somehow that was possible. As a biomedical engineer, I had been studying cochlear implants, so that was one particular aspect that I wanted, the access to the low end mm-hmm. in the musical, you know, spectrum.
To the low frequencies.
And I got that. And so it was like my main motive to get to Medel was that.
So how often do you listen to music now?
Oh, at least 2-3 hours a day. Right after the activation, the first thing I did was buy high-fi speakers and I store them on my computer. And I was listening to music from the first day. Mm-hmm. I shut the speakers loud. I was in the office alone. And so I cranked up the music, and I'll be working and listening to music all the time. And because I had been without music for so long, it was like a rehabilitation process for me. Mm-hmm. I wanted to learn to appreciate it. In the beginning, it didn't make sense to me. It was a lot of sound without detail. Mm-hmm. But very quickly, after a few months, the fine detail, individual, discrete sounds started becoming alive to me. And the first thing I noticed in the music, you know, spectrum was the snare and of the drum, because in the past I had heard music like a big mix of many different sounds without being able to tell the different instruments. Mm-hmm. I could tell a little bit of voice, a little bit of music, but I couldn't really appreciate the diversity of it. And when I started hearing the different instruments, the vocals separately, mm-hmm. and that transformed my experience with music in a big way.
Mm-hmm. And seeing this progress probably was also a big motivation to you to continue.
It made me so focused on listening and spending as much time as I could listening to music. That was a big driving factor. And as it got better and better, I got even more hooked into it.
Yeah.
And then I started exploring different types of music. Mm-hmm. And in the beginning, it was like soft, mellow music. Mm-hmm. And then I expanded my repertoire of music to very complex music, even orchestral music. One of my favorite songs is Black Magic Woman with the percussion, mm-hmm. and the drums and the highs and the guitar. It was crazy. So I was taken with that detail in the music that I never had before in my life.
So let me ask you, what was the last live concert that you attended?
I've been to a few. My favorite one was in the first one, live concert, was going to Andrea Bocelli concert in Italy. We went all the way to Italy, mm-hmm. just to see his live concert in his hometown of Lazzatico, mm-hmm. in Italy. And it was a beautiful trip, and it was one of the highlights. My wife and I, musical journey.
So let's maybe go a little bit more into detail in terms of how would you describe the sound quality of when you listen to music?
It's amazing. It's very natural. In the beginning, it was a little harsh, mm-hmm. because when I got activated, you know, my brain was not used to getting so much sound information. It came at you really hard. But after 6 months, it became, the most miraculous thing, mm-hmm. because you started hearing little fine details, and it got better over time and better, progressively better. And so and that improvement, even though it was small, it was significant to keep me motivated, mm-hmm. and I kept just listening to music, to people talking. I also listened to lectures to practice my speech discrimination, and it's been an amazing journey. It transformed my life completely. Mm-hmm.
So I know that you're a bilateral cochlear implant user, so I want to ask, when you received your second implant, how did that change how music sounded to you?
It improved dramatically. I was enjoying music with my first cochlear implant, and I had a hearing aid on the other side. and the hearing aid was getting kind of behind, was not helping much. Mm-hmm. And so after 2 years, I decided to go with the second one. Mm-hmm. And it took a lot of work to get the first one to a very nice, you know, experience with the rehab, with music and speech.
To get and to then, a comfortable yeah, level.
Yeah. And then the second one, I thought, oh, it's going to take me a little while to get used to it. And I was shocked. Right after activation, I could see the amazing improvement overnight. Mm-hmm. But I expected it to take me a year or 2 years to get to the same level as the, mm-hmm. the first one. It took me 1 month. And 1 month, the dimension of sounds increased exponentially mm-hmm. in a crazy way. I was thinking like 1 + 1 better, but now it was like it went from this dimension to the whole room overnight. And the summation of the sounds from both sides, it's massive. It's kind of amplify everything, but makes everything so much richer. And so music as a result became even more phenomenal for mm-hmm. me going bilateral.
So while you were doing that with music, what was easier to pick up and what was more challenging?
The most challenging with the music was the lyrics were always a big challenge.
Okay.
Because I could hear the music, I could always hear the vocals, but I could never hear the lyrics. But the interesting thing with the lyrics is that they started coming through the music mm-hmm. over time. I started capturing more and more of the words in the lyrics as I became more experienced listening to music. And that surprised me quite a bit mm-hmm. because I had never understood the lyrics in the song ever. Mm-hmm. And the ability to actually capture those in many of the songs was surprised me. And I also noticed that reading the lyrics while listening to music is so easy to follow them. Mm-hmm. And as you become familiar with the song, then when you listen to the music, you can hear the lyrics very clearly, mm-hmm. even with cochlear implants. Mm-hmm. You know, it just becomes part of the song, the music. It takes time and practice.
Do you think that, you know, I know that understanding the lyrics and music is a challenge for many cochlear implant users. So do you think, you know, reading the lyrics in addition is a good exercise to improve in that aspect?
That is really, when sometimes I'm relaxing and I'm not driving or doing anything, and then I use Spotify mm-hmm. and I listen to my favorite songs and I open up the lyrics and follow them. And
so basically, Spotify is a nice platform that allows you reading the lyrics in addition, which comes in handy for your training purposes.
Most of the songs on Spotify now have lyrics, not 100%, but most of, I would say maybe 90% of them have lyrics included. And if you have a quiet moment, it's a good way to enjoy the music. Especially when you try to listen to new music you never heard before, and you like that melody, that music, and you get captivated by it. I always open the lyrics to see what the songs are behind, and then I just follow the message of the music. It helps you to connect to the music mm-hmm. if you know what's in the lyrics.
Yeah, So considering your success with music, how would you describe, in summary, your music rehabilitation process? Like, what are like the key messages that you maybe would share with others?
I would say, you know, just like talking with some people with cochlear implants, they say, I don't like music. It's too hard. You know, start with simple music in the beginning, soft, gentle music, and then allow that to grow into you. And then you go to more and more complex music over time.
Yeah, and I think an important word here that I was looking for is to explore.
Explore, exactly. I do explore music, and I was kind of hooked in the 1970s music because I was, when I had my body aid, that's the music I was listening to. So I liked that music because I remembered it. But quickly, I discovered so many other singers, more recent, and a lot of beautiful music that I did not know about. And even today, I keep listening to new music because you never know what comes out. And it's amazing. I'm always adding favorites to my my music list when I discover new music that I like.
Yeah. That's wonderful. Well, thank you so much, Joe, for joining us here, for sharing your experience. I'm sure that many can relate to that. Not everyone is a musician, but many love music. And so it's wonderful to hear what people can do when it comes to practicing music listening.
Yes. Thank you for inviting me. I always love sharing my story, my journey, especially the one about music too. Yeah.